afternoon baseball here on the show. Today we've got a good matchup in store between the St. Louis Cardinals and the Milwaukee Brewers. In now, Colton Wong, and we are ready for some daytime baseball. The 3-1, and that misses for ball four, so it's a five-pitch walk to get us started here this afternoon.
Batting second.
The next to bat for St. Louis, Dexter Fowler. His prior history versus this arm, he's gone 2-for-5. Not quick enough that time, and he's lucky to get another chance. Count remains full. Pulled toward right center field. After it is Yelich. He gets there to make the play for the first out of the inning. And that brings up Paul Goldschmidt. 9 at-bats for him in the series so far, and he's collected a pair of hits. Out of the stretch, the 3-2 pitch home. Slapped hard the opposite way. In there, a base hit. Oh, and the throw back in is a wild one. The tag comes down, and they're going to get him at third. Aggressive base running there following some shoddy defensive play, but it doesn't work out for him. So now to the plate, Matt Carpenter. Count even at 2-2. Started to go. They'll look for the appeal down to third and ring him up, says the third base umpire. He's gone. Striding into the box, Lorenzo Cain. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. The 1-1.
Ball. Two ball. One strike.
Slider misses, and he's in danger of losing him here. 3-1.
He's only 4 pitches in, but he doesn't look too sharp to start the day off.
High in the air out to center field. Thomas has it for route number 1. Here's Brock Bolton now. He had a couple of hits in that ball game last night. Gets him on the mound. And he can't make the play as he overruns it, but that should be scored as an infield single. At the plate, Christian Yelich. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball. And a breaking ball in the dirt that time for a ball.
We're seeing a good AB here from the 3-hole hitter. If he can work a walk or pick up a hit here, he's going to put that cleanup guy in a really good position to do some damage in this first inning.
Batting four.
So two men are on with one man out. And in at the plate steps Keston Hiura. The 1-1. Hit sharply toward the right side. And this is going to wind up as extra bases as that'll play one for sure and maybe a second. As he arrives at second without a play, as they jump ahead with a run scoring on the play. Standing in now, Omar Narvaez, fouled away. And another foul ball. Now another 2-2. Yanked high and deep down the line in right. And it's a foul ball. He's set and the 2-2 pitch. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Catch made in center. Here comes the runner from third. And the run is in to score from third. It's a 2-0 ball game. Digging in now for the Brewers, Avisail Garcia. And Milwaukee with an opportunity for more damage here in the first. And that misses ball four, so it's first and second now with two out. Here's Eric Sogard. It was a two-hit effort for him, including a home run in last night's game. Here's the payoff pitch. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. And a swing and a miss here. So it took him 31 pitches, but the side is finally retired. So Paul DeJong digs in next. He's ready for his first at-bat of this early season contest.
Hey, we're still in the early stages in this one. They're only down by a couple of runs, but it's really key for this leadoff guy to try to get on and get a big inning started.
Three balls and a strike to the Cardinals shortstop.
He walked a guy back in the first, and now he's looking like he might hand out another free pass to the leadoff guy here. You can't be walking a guy an inning and think you're going to have any success.
Got him. So one away here with the bases empty. And here now is the catcher, Yadier Molina.
Yadier Molina.
2-2. Lifted in the air to right field. Under it is Yelich, and there are two away now. So coming to the plate, Tyler O'Neill. Two hits and eight tries for the series. And he takes ball two, and it's 2-1.
Big sweeping breaking ball right there. Good pitch. But if he wants to get him to swing at it, he'll have to bring it in a little bit closer to the strike zone.
Two balls and two strikes now. Even at two balls and two strikes, here's the pitch.
Wow, talk about a waste pitch on 2-2. That one wasn't even close. I don't know anyone that would have swung at that pitch.
And he misses here for ball four. Already two walks surrendered in his first couple of innings of work. The 1-1 home is strike two swinging.
Threw that fastball right by him. He had no chance to get the barrel of that one.
A swing and a miss on a ball way outside the strike zone, and the inning is over. Switch hitter Justin Smoke steps up. He's set to lead off the home half of the second. Now the 2-1 pitch.
You can bet they'd love ball four here. That gives the pitcher on deck an obvious bunt situation to move the runner into scoring position.
And he takes ball four. Leadoff man's aboard here to begin the home half of the second. One-one. Now a bunt attempt here, and Goldschmidt able to put the squeeze on it here. One away. In now is Lorenzo Cain. 0-for-1 here in the early going. And that misses 2-2.
Wow, that's 40 pitches for him already. This doesn't have the makings of a start that he's going to go very deep.
Oh, and he can't catch up to the fastball as he swings and misses for the second out. So the runner at first here with two gone in the inning. And that'll bring up the versatile utility man, Brock Holt. The 1-1. Pitch is piling up, 44, and he's not clear of the second yet. And it's fouled away. Brock Holt now with a full count.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
Line drive to left. And that'll get down for a base hit. And the throw in gets away from him. Throw comes in quickly from left, so even on the hit and run, they'll hold thanks to first and second here. Into the box now, Christian Yelich. And here's a fastball, not close, as he runs it to 2-1 now. All even now, 2-2. Try trying to fool them with the changeup, but he won't offer it. It's 3-2.
Boy, his pitch count has really spiked here in this inning. He's up to over 50 already.
Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. The next 3-2. And that pitch misses for ball four. So some intrigue now as the bases are loaded here with two away. Next for Milwaukee, Keston Hiura. An RBI double is what he was credited with his first time around. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2.
This is a huge pitch right here. I don't think he wants to go 3-2 and have those runners be in motion. Look for him to be aggressive with what he thinks is his best pitch right now.
And he comes back to get him. So a great job pitching out of it with the bases loaded. Stepping in for the Cardinals, Jack Flaherty, 9-1-2 due up. Cardinals pitcher up there with a 1-2 count.
Boy, he center cut that fastball. It comes in the high 90s, but that's a dangerous location no matter how hard you're throwing.
The next 1-2 pitch. Hit down the third baseline. But this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. Swing and a miss as he starts the third the same way he ended the second, with a punch out one way. Here's Colton Wong now. He's picked up three hits in the series and driven in four along the way. Hit hard on the ground to second and into center field as he's aboard with a one out single.
Now back. Right fielder, Dexter.
To the plate now, Fowler. Dexter Fowler. Outside, 2-1. Fouled off. The 2-2 is a swing and a miss. That's strike three. So a runner at first with two away, and that'll bring up the big bat of Paul Goldschmidt. Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way. Yanked the slider across that time, laid off for a ball. And now a slider in on the hands, and he's lucky that one didn't come and get him.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
And he tries to go to a knee to block it, but it's by him down the right field line. Wong rounds the corner and is headed home. He scores. And the deficit is down to only one now.
The third baseman, number 13, Matt Carpenter.
Into the box, Matt Carpenter. Two balls and a strike to Matt Carpenter.
Two balls, one strike.
It's going to even up the count at 2-2. Goldschmidt stands at second with two gone. Liner toward right center. And that'll split the gap as it should be extra bases. He pulls into second safely as a run comes across to score on the play, tying the ball game. So now to the plate, Paul DeJong. And that misses ball four, so it's first and second now with two out. Here's the catcher, Yadier Molina, 0-for-1 for him here in this one. Ready with the 2-1.
Call didn't go his way on 2-1, but it's important here on 3-1 to still make a quality pitch. You have to have the mindset that you're still the one in the driver's seat.
Heading out towards shallow right, Yelich will reach out with one hand to make the catch on the move, and that ends the inning. Now at the plate, Omar Narvaez. Ready to deliver the 1-2. Looked like the fastball got away from him there. It's ball two. Line drive to left. O'Neill has him played perfectly as he puts it away for out number one. Now at the plate, Abisail Garcia. He drew a base on balls his first time up. Bases are empty, one man out. Well hit, but also well fouled into the seats in left. And he fouls this one off. This one's down to third. Carpenter has it. And there are two away now. So two away in the Brewers half of the third. And that'll bring in utility man extraordinaire Eric Sogard. Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. This should end the inning as it's sent out to second. Wong is there. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. Stepping in, Tyler O'Neill reached base via the walk in his first plate appearance.
Ball.
A full count, three balls and two strikes.
Count is full.
Protecting with two strikes, went out of the zone that time, but he stays alive. Grounded back up the middle, and a base hit, so the leadoff man is aboard.
The center fielder, number 35, Lane.
At the plate now, Lane Thomas. Oh, a fastball swung on and missed, and for the second time today, he's gone on strikes.
Jack Lane.
Now the 1-1 pitch. And he'll smartly just ensure that this stays a foul ball. And he pulls this one back in time, 2-2.
You certainly know he's not trying to work around the pitcher, but sometimes the hardest thing to do is to throw a strike to a guy that you know won't swing the bat.
And they'll try and play for one here as he gets this one down. And the off-balance throw gets him. Nice play for the out. And now back to the leadoff spot in the St. Louis lineup. Stepping in, Colton Wong. He scored after reaching on a single in his last time up.
Yeah, and they take another single right here. That third base coach is dying to wave his arms. I wouldn't be surprised if anything hit hard through the infield, he's going to wave them.
Two runs, five hits, and no errors so far for the Redbirds. Hit sharply on the ground. Oh, and he has some trouble with it. Throw on to smoke it first, and the side is retired. Here's Justin Smoke now. Now the 1-1 pitch. There's a fastball swung on and missed. Lined hard to center field. And that's a base hit, so the pressure's on to open up the inning. Ryan Braun come on to pinch hit now with a runner at first and nobody out. Two runs, four hits, and no errors on the Milwaukee line score so far. That's back toward the mound. This will be a tough turn, however. There's one, but he'll put this in his pocket and be content with just the one out. And in to hit next is Lorenzo Cain. He flew out his first time around and then was a strikeout victim most recently. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Swung on and missed. 1-2 now. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. The 1-2. Is laid off for ball two.
This is a fun guy to watch when he's up there. Really battles. Doesn't take any pitches off. He's a grinder. Always seems to make it difficult on the opposing pitcher.
Taken in by Carpenter. Wong for one. On to Goldschmidt, and it's in time. A double play, and the side is retired. J.P. Fireisen will come on and make his fourth appearance in this campaign.
number 76.
Here's Dexter Fowler now. No hits to this point. Here it comes on 1-1.
Ball.
On deck, the powerful right-handed bat of Paul Goldschmidt. And a good eye here as he takes ball four, and it's a base on balls to lead off the fifth inning.
Now batting.
Digging in and looking for more, Paul Goldschmidt. He'll try to follow up the double in his last at-bat with another big hit right here.
Yeah, he did a great job to go down and get that one his last at bat. But I got to think they're going to pitch him up, maybe elevate something in the zone. Interested to see how he approaches this next AB.
Takes this the other way to right. And that's in there. Base hit. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
Now batting, the third baseman, Matt.
Stepping in now, Matt Carpenter. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. Working for the punch out and the offering. Lifted down the line and left. And this will not be caught. It's a foul ball. The 2-2 one more time. Now a swing, and this ball is crushed straight away center field. Looking up is Kane.
Gone!
Wow, talk about a guy getting hot, right? Hits a bomb, hit one yesterday. Usually when he gets hot, he starts to hit them in bunches, and this could be the beginning of a very, very good hot streak.
Corbin Burnes will come on and make his fourth appearance in this campaign. Into the box now, Paul DeJong. Ground ball foul down the left side. Still 1-2 as he fouls it away. Here's the pitch. Swing and a miss as he ran the fastball right by him for the first down. Yadi Molina digging in now. Three runs already home here. And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball.
Hey, that's a nice take by the batter right there, but that's a non-competitive off-speed pitch. Got to do better to at least entice a swing.
And it's up to a 3-2 full count now. And this is sliced foul into the stands in right, out of play. Hard hit ball to second. And this will get over his glove as he couldn't quite get up all the way. It's a base hit. To the plate now, Tyler O'Neill. On the ground to third. The second for one. On to smoke in time for an inning-ending double play. Stepping into the box, Brock Holt. Couple of singles to his credit thus far. The 3-1 pitch. Takes a strike for a full count now, 3-2.
Count is full. Ball, two strikes.
And he turns on one, sending it high and deep to right. Back goes Fowler. Out of here, into the visitor's bullpen. John Gant will come on and make his fourth appearance in this campaign.
Number 53, John Gant.
At the plate, Christian Yelich. And now a curveball that's low and in the dirt for a ball. It's 2-1. Ground ball right side straight into the shift. And an off-balance throw is in time as he takes one away. Wow.
Now back.
Striding forward now, the Brewers cleanup hitter, Keston Hiura. He was sent packing on strikes in his last trip.
Yeah, Maddie, and hopefully he got it out of his system, especially now he's got a bear down. He gets the two strikes in this spot, has to put the ball in play.
Just staying alive, putting together a really good at-bat here. Pulled high in the air out to left field. O'Neill waits on it. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away. Stepping in, Omar Narvaez hit the ball pretty well in his last at-bat, but it resulted in a line-out.
Yeah, Matty, it's always a little frustrating when you square one up. You hit a solid line drive like he did, and all you have to show for it is a jog back to the dugout. That can get in your head for a little while.
He's fallen behind now, 3-1. Popped him up. Carpenter shading to his right, and the inning is over. Coming to the plate now, Lane Thomas. And he's likely just trying to put one in play here. 0-for-2 with a pair of strikeouts thus far. The 2-1. Takes a pass and misses. That's strike two.
When the pitcher on the mound's establishing this kind of heater, you got to come off everything else.
Oh, look at the diving stop. Got him. Tommy Edman will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here.
Pitcher for the group. Number 19.
And right into the shift, but a foul ball. 1-2 the count now. Now here's the pitch. Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble. Around first, digging for two. And he is in at second base with a one-out double.
Now back, second base.
So now to the plate, Colton Wong. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Keene is under it. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away. Ready now, Dexter Fowler. Runner in scoring position with two gone.
Dexter.
Runner in scoring position at second with two down. Fowler behind a ball and two strikes.
Hey, this guy's got an 89-mile-an-hour changeup. There was a time when 89 was a pretty good fastball.
Well outside with the curveball for a ball. The 2-2. Hit out towards second. Oh, and he can't pick it up cleanly. Throw on to smoke at first, and the side is retired. John Brebbia will come on out of the bullpen as he'll be appearing in his third game this season. Stepping into the box, Avisail Garcia. He was retired via the ground ball last time up.
Things not looking very good so far in this one, but we're still in the middle innings. They're down by a couple of runs, and this would be the right place and the right time to get something going. The last thing they want to do is to try to come from behind and win this one in the eighth or ninth inning.
And he missed with it up and in to even things at 2-2. Hard liner, but picked up on a hop. Throw just does beat him to the bag, as that was pretty close. So stepping in, Eric Sogard. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. The 1-1 home. Now a swing and a ground ball for Wong at second. In time to first, and there are two away. Digging in the switch hitter, Justin Smoke. He singled his last time up. As anticipated, here's a ground ball now to the right side. They'll whip this one to first in time, and that ends the inning. Corey Knebel will come on to pitch now as he'll move into the eighth spot in the lineup on the double switch here. Jed Jerko will also come on now as he'll move into the pitcher's number nine hold in the order here on that double switch.
Batting nine, number five, Jed Jerko.
A 1-1 home. Knebel is a guy known for his lights out stuff. He tends to rack up strikeout numbers at a very high rate. However, he does at times get wild. Walks have come back to bite him on more than one occasion.
You know, it's not uncommon, Matty V, for a relief pitcher to come in with really good stuff. And it seems like he's either really hit miss. He'll rack up a lot of strikeouts, but if he's not quite on, he'll also rack up a lot of base on balls. And that can cause a pitching coach and a manager to really start to pull their hair out.
Here's the 1-1. Down the left field line and deep. And that's going to land foul. Now another 1-2. And that's going to be high, 2-2 now. And he strikes him out as well. So make it back-to-back punch outs here to the first two men he faces out of the bullpen.
Paul DeYoung.
And a knuckle curve missed that time, 2-1. Just behind the fastball there, two strikes now.
Boy, he looks strong out there on the mound this inning. He's got a chance to punch out the side in order and against the middle of the order, too.
2-2 pitch is fouled away. And there's a fastball well off the plate inside.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
Fouled away. Eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. Swing, high drive, left field and deep. Back goes Garcia. On the warning track, he makes the catch.
Please join for the traditional 7-inning stretch.
Jordan Hicks gets the call from the pen to take over on the mound and start the home seventh.
Number 12.
Here's Jed Jerko now. He's newly entered into the ballgame, so this will be his first trip to the plate here in inning number 7.
Even though we're moving into the back end of this game, they're only down by a couple of runs. You know that old slogan, a bloop and a blast? They could certainly use that right now.
Swing and a miss on the slider, and that's out number 1. Now back to the top of the lineup, stepping in, Lorenzo Cain. He's hitless in 3 at-bats to this point. The 1-2. Misses, ball 2.
Two balls, 2 strikes.
And it's fouled away. 1 out, nobody on. And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's worked it full now at 3-2.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
And, whoa, awfully close, but it's ball 4, according to Woody Keller. Tried to bury one down and away, but it's a full count now, 3-2.
Not a bad time right here to put that runner in motion. 3-2 count, you send the runner, and if it's a bad pitch, it's ball 4.
Payoff pitch one more time. Lifted down the line and left. And this will wind up a foul ball. He'll try it again, 3-2. Line towards center field. In there, a base hit. The throw to third. And he's out on a strong throw. So with a left-handed hitter waiting, they'll go to their own left-hander out of the bullpen. Standing in now, Christian Yelich. And it's up to a 3-2 full count now.
He'll be fine coming out of the bullpen in this one if he can keep the ball around the knees like that.
Ground ball sent back up the middle. And that's through for a base hit, making 1-for-2 in this one. And the throw will come in quickly from center, so despite the hit and run, they won't get the extra base here. At the plate now, Keston Hiura. Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble. And that two-run lead could be in real jeopardy. It's extra bases. And both runners are in to score on a clutch at-bat that time as we are tied at 5.
Now batting,
into the box, Omar Narvaez. Oh, my goodness, that nearly got him as he had to back away from it. It's ball 3.
Well, that'll wake everyone up. Anytime you buzz the towel like that, there's reason for people to start getting a little bit edgy.
Now ball hit foul down the line in right and in amongst the fans. Payoff pitch on its way. And a slider swung on and missed, and the side is retired. David Phelps will come on in relief as he'll make his second appearance of the season so far. Settling in now, Yadier Molina. It was a single for him in his last at-bat.
I mean, Yadi, when he first broke on the scene, was a defender first and foremost. You can't say that anymore. I mean, he's evolved into a really, really nice offensive player.
Yelich able to take this one in, and there's your first down. Ready for another chance? Tyler O'Neill, a hit and two at-bats for him at this point in the ballgame. 1-1, here it comes. Pulls this one in the air out to left. There to play it is Garcia, and that becomes out number 2. Standing in, Lane Thomas. He could really use a knock here, 0-for-3 in the game so far. 1-1 count, the pitch. Shaking his head on that knuckle curve, 1-2. Breaks is bad as this one's popped up, and he'll avoid the fragments out there to make the catch that ends the inning. Ryan Helsley will come on to pitch now as he'll move into the 8th spot in the lineup on the double switch here. Harrison Bader is into the ballgame as well as he'll slide into the pitcher's spot, hitting 9th now on the double switch.
Batting 9, number 48, Harrison Bader.
Now a ball crushed high in the air, deep to left, way back there, and that one is long gone. To the plate now, Eric Sogard. And it's 1-2. To 2 balls and 2 strikes now. This one's down to 3rd. On to 1st, so a good bounce back pitch there as he gets the ground ball for the first out. Ben Gamel will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher.
Number 15, Ben Gamel.
Called strike 2 on the cutter, and he's behind in the count now, 1-2. Back up the middle and in for a base hit. Genesis Cabrera answers the call now, looking to get this one onto the 9th inning without any trouble. In now, Jed Jerko. Just off the outside as he can't catch the corner. Cabrera, 23 years old. He's in his rookie year here at the big league level. Good opposite field power here, taken high and deep to right. And that's a base hit, one for two in his first couple of plate appearances. And they'll have runners at the corners following the one-out single.
The center fielder, number six.
Into the box now, Lorenzo Cain. Hit high and deep to left field. Going back is the left fielder. Gone! At the plate, Brock Holt. Hit on the ground out to short. Throw just in time, and oh, that was awfully close. So two gone now in the Brewers' half of the eighth,
and that'll bring up Christian Yelich.
Four runs here in this half inning. One and two for Christian Yelich. With this one almost in the books, the story was clearly the long ball. What are your thoughts on this offense, fellas?
Well, Matty V, I don't know what your thoughts are, D-Roll, but boy, when the weather starts to warm up and the ball starts jumping out like this, it's clear that the pitchers need to start making better pitches.
Yeah, just great approach. No one really chased today. Really stayed staunch on their ability to get that pitcher to come into the heart of the plate, and they did damage with it.
And the inning will continue as that's through for a two-out hit. The tag, and they'll get him at second. That, the side is retired. Alex Claudio comes on from the pen, hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the ninth.
Number 58, Alex Claudio.
Stepping in now, Harrison Bader. High and deep to left center field. Back goes Garcia at the track. The wall. Gone into the home bullpen for a home run. So now to the plate, Colton Wong. Claudio has seen his role change with those one-batter lefty specialists going the way of the dodo as a part of MLB's pace of play initiatives. And he lost him here on 3-2 as that pitch misses. It's ball four.
Now batter.
Into the box now, Dexter Fowler. He was a ground-out victim last time up. And the sinking fastball called strike three, and that's out number one. Josh Hader answers the call from dugout as he'll try to record the final two outs of this one. Paul Goldschmidt will be the first to greet him here as he'll stand in with a runner at first and one away. The 1-1.
Hey, this is a real pesky hitter right here. As a pitcher, you really like to keep this guy off the bases. This is a guy that kind of sets the tables for big innings.
Ground ball to second. This could be two. Holt for one on to first, and he rolls a double play ball to end it here as this ball game is over.
Yeah, that's the way you want to finish a three-game home series, breaking out the brooms and sweeping the other guys right out of here.
9-6, the final tally in this one. The Brewers came through late, taking the lead in the eighth to secure the victory. David Phelps claims the win out of the pen, his first. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian, and you've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to theshownation.com.
For the victorious Brewers, 9 runs on 13 hits. No error. They left 7 men on base. For St. Louis, 6 runs, 10 hits. No error. They left 8 men on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 58 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this afternoon. And we remind you to please drive home safely.